Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and welcome to my latest Let's Play gaming video, Train Simulator 2022. We're going to be using an SD70M, I believe it is. And this is an EMD locomotive, just like I promised. And we're going to be taking a heavy oil train across the Donner's Pass. So I'm going to let yous enjoy the ride, and we'll do the thumbnail first, set up the lights, and then we'll get moving. Okay, we do have a caution signal at the start, so we will have to be mindful of the next signal up ahead, and I do have a heavy oil train as well, so I will do a tab just to see if the signal ahead is a danger, and which it is, but I'm not sure how far it is away from us, so we will have to be mindful on how much speed we do, so I'm just going to come off that now. Just testing the brakes, folks, as I'm using the EMD enhancements for the sounds, also by Searchlight Simulations as well, of which are produced by MLW, of which they are installed in my train simulator installation. So I'm just testing the dynamic brakes here, folks, just to see which works best, use the direct brakes or use the electronic brakes, well, the dynamic brakes or the air brakes, really. But at least the good news is, at least we do have clear weather, so I just need to be mindful of the next signal, of which is at danger. As you can see on the left, folks, we do have a couple of dash 9s on an intermodal train, and the GE sound pack that I covered on the last Let's Play does also apply the sirens to that train as well. I'm thankful though that the brakes on this locomotive are very responsive, unlike the last one. So I'm just thankful that there is no, well, the brakes are responsive and I should be able to stop at any red signals. And here we go. I believe that is two SD40-2s on the back. And all those trains do come with the route as well, folks. I will cover the Dash 9, but I don't know if it'll be this month or it'll be in June, but that's when I'm going to be doing the next lot of Train Simulator 2022 videos. And I do plan to do some from mid-May as well, so there'll be plenty to see on the Train Simulator front anyways. Okay then folks, I just checked with the signaller. I believe we are following another train, so I will have to drive with caution. That's the alerter going off. Although I did operate the brakes, I think it only works if you use the horn, the bell, and of course the combined power handle. But it is grand to have a working alerter on this train as well. So I'm just gonna have to bring the speed down so we do not go too fast. As unlike normal mode, when you turn off the career scoring, it doesn't warn you if you're breaking the speed limit. As well, I would like it to alert me that I am breaking the speed limit, as I don't always look at the HUD, folks. I'm so busy focusing on where I'm going. I'm looking at the windscreen. I'm not really looking at the bottom of the display screen, really. I'm just looking straight ahead and concentrating. So it's grand to have the alerter and stuff on this train. And I'm just using manual brakes, as you can see there. Just like with the Dash 8, folks, and all the other trains that this sound mod applies to, it does cancel the alerter or the vigilance system, whatever you want to call it. It does cancel it if you move a control, sound the horn, operate the bell, but it doesn't work when you're putting the brakes on and off. That's the only controls it's not linked to. So Anyways, we'll take the brakes off. And we might have to wait at this signal, folks. I don't know. Unless there's another train coming. I'm really not sure. But I don't mind. I do like a challenge, you know. As that's what makes Train Simulator fun for me. As simple A to B runs, they do look, they are okay, but get a bit repetitive. And I like to do something more challenging, you know. Another thing I need to remember as well is, folks, I have to be mindful of the signals in career mode, because if I run any at red, it will boot me out of the scenario and I will have to start over. So I'll just have to be mindful of that as well. Okay then, we can proceed as normal. I don't have to take any action here, so I'm just using notch 2 just to get my train back up to speed. We have a caution on my line, so I will have to be mindful of the next signal. But I don't mind. I do like a challenge, you know. So, something nice and different, folks. do hope you are enjoying this one, folks. As you know, it's been a long time since I've covered the Donner Pass route. It is nice to use some Southern Pacific traction, and I did do some EMD locomotives on this occasion, as I didn't do any in the last bank of Let's Plays. But anyway, folks, just going to be mindful of the speed and that, because the signal up ahead will be a stop one, so just need to be mindful of that so we don't get kicked off the scenario, as we are in career mode. Gotta be honest, folks, I really wish I was going uphill, as then I could show off the sounds even better, just to see what the engine sounds sound like. As to be honest, I've not been able to use much power, if any, so it's just mostly coasting downhill and using the brakes and stuff. So hopefully we will get an opportunity use the power, but I think I'm following another train here, as this signal is, or it was, a danger, but I'm just being cautious here for the reasons I've already said. Well, I think we're okay now, folks. That looks like a caution signal to me, so I think we're definitely following another train. So, no issues there, as it's just cleared from stop to caution, so that's cool. Okay then, folks, we are coming down to level ground at long last, so I should get an opportunity to show off the engine sound of this EMD 710 sound enhancement pack that is also available from Searchlight Simulations. Just like with the other one, this sound add-on is definitely free of charge, and it is compatible with most of the EMD locomotives, mostly the older add-ons and stuff, but it would be grand to see that updated to be more compatible with newer trains and stuff. But anyways, just being mindful of his speed, folks, as I don't want to run the risk of passing this signal when it's showing stop, as it will kick me out of the scenario, as that is just one of the things I detest about career mode, and I really really dislike career mode, to be honest with you, folks. Sounds, but I will have to back off the power in a moment, folks. Okay, I just want you to have a listen to the engine. there is an exact replica of my train, which is identical to the one I'm driving here. And I'm just being mindful of the speed, folks, as I'm not sure if the signal up ahead has changed or not. So it's quite a slow run, this one is, folks, but nonetheless, I will just proceed with caution and be ready to stop if I need to. Right, the signal has cleared. I'm going to have a nose. I'm going to be nosy and see what train is ahead of us, if it is a train ahead of us. I've got a feeling it is, or it could be an invisible blocker. I don't know. Anyway, folks, I think this checkpoint will be where this scenario will end, and our signal's just cleared to green as well, so no bother there. Unfortunately, I was unable to show this train under any manoeuvres where I could use the power, as most of it is downhill. I wish in some ways it was coming the other way, as it would be nice to use full power, not shake going uphill with this heavy train. That'd certainly make it easy. And we do have another NPC train coming our way anyways, folks, and that'll be the last one before we reach the checkpoint of where this scenario will finish, okay? I believe it's another GE-9 44CW, and I promise you I will cover that in another Let's Play, folks. As you know, that is one of my favourite diesel locomotives, and this scenario will finish once we get to this checkpoint, folks, okay? So I just want to say to you, if you stayed with me throughout the whole video, folks, I just want to say to you a big thank you for watching all the way through. I do appreciate your feedback, your comments, your input and suggestions. And as you know, I do hope that the GE-9 pack with the BNSF liveries will be available to outside the United States customers. As you know, I'm a big fan of the BNSF trains, although sadly I can't obtain too many of them at the moment, as I'm in the UK, Northern Ireland to be exact, but same rules apply here. But I do hope more and more BNSF American trains and routes become available to the UK customers and European customers and worldwide customers as well, as I do plan to make some scenarios using the trains and the stock for many of the American routes that I have, such as the Surfliner route and stuff, as I do like freight. But anyway folks, I'm just gonna call it here, okay? We will be required to stop at this signal folks, and that will be where this let's play will finish, I'm assuming. But I think we've been playing this for nearly enough an hour now, just looking at my clock. I've been recording for about roughly an hour, or maybe just under. But anyways, it'll soon be time to wind it down folks, and till next time, I just want to say to yous, big thank you for watching, take care of yourselves and each other, all the best, God bless, and I'll catch yous in the next one.